We engage with a number of pharma companies before completing these experiments. We design the experiments by talking to large pharma companies that are potential partners. And therefore, it was a stepping stone towards our business model.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Ajan Reginald, the CEO of Roquefort Therapeutics. And Ajan, good to see you. How are you?
Very well. Hello.
Good. Good to see you. And I know that you've had some significant news out today, and we'll talk about that in just a second, but it all relates to your siRNA program. And maybe you can start there and just remind everyone a little bit about the technology and what this program is.
Yeah. siRNA stands for small interfering RNA, and it's a new type of medicine which allows us to block proteins that we don't want to be expressed. And by blocking these proteins, we can help to treat disease.
Yeah. Are specific diseases that you would be looking at for this, or is there a number of ones that can be utilized with it?
Yes, we've used this previously in cancer. So we've been able to demonstrate in validated in vivo models, so in models which are similar to the disease, that you can block this in cancer cells. The first that we're announcing at the moment is that we can also do that in a much broader set of diseases, which are in the area of immunology and inflammation. And immunology and inflammation is important because it's a bigger set of diseases. And it's also one that big pharma companies are looking at increasingly at the moment.
And that's where really today's news comes into, and you've got some data to share with us and really encouraging data as well.
Yes, I would say that's right. Yeah, it's encouraging data. We've been able to show very significantly that we can reduce the protein STAT-6. And STAT-6 is what we're looking to reduce in lots of different inflammatory and immunology disease states.
Yeah. Can you talk a bit about the amount of people around the world that could be affected by something like this? What you described a little earlier sounds like it's a pretty large market to be looking at.
Yes, certainly. Immunology, inflammatory immunology, I&I, is probably the big field in the last couple of years. You've got obesity, and then now you've got immunology and inflammatory. And so these are the big growth areas that you're seeing a lot of big pharma companies getting into, and also a lot of deals. So a lot of acquisition of companies and a lot of licensing of products in this area. And they're multi-billion dollar markets. They're in sort of in the $20 to $30 billion market range.
And so these kind of conversations you're having right now, especially with data like you have now about, you know, potentially licensing out and things like that, those are conversations you have to have, I would guess.
Yeah, it's topical. A lot of deals getting done in the I&I area at the moment, more generally, and very specifically in STAT-6. There was a large deal completed in August last year with Sanofi and Reculux. So Sanofi licensed a STAT-6 program, which is in preclinical development, very similar to ours, for $125 million upfront and total deal value of $1.2 billion. So you know, this is a very hot field, and we're well placed. We're highly competitive in that field.
Absolutely. Next stage is now for development. What do you do with this data outside of the conversations with other people? But what will be the next stages of development?
Yeah, I think the focus for us actually is those conversations. They're probably more than conversations. They're quite active dialogues. We engage with a number of pharma companies before completing these experiments. We design the experiments by talking to large pharma companies that are potential partners. And therefore, it was a stepping stone towards our business model. You know, and our business model is to find this breakthrough innovation early and then to demonstrate that it works in these areas of high unmet medical need, which are very attractive to pharma companies, through the experimental results that we're producing.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Ajan, thank you so much. Congratulations on this, and we look forward to continuing to follow your story as it unravels, okay?
Very good. Thank you.
All right, there's Ajan Reginald. He's the CEO of Roquefort Therapeutics.